God. Oh shit, sorry. I forgot you had that bloody nose. Are you right? Yeah, shit. Oh my God, sorry, I forgot you had a blocked up nose. Are you okay? Sorry, it's just been so long since I could see you. And, you know, are you alright now? Sorry for nearly strangling your lungs back there. Hey, how can you blame me? It's been months, okay? How could I not be emotional? It's been killing me. Not being able to see you, talk to you, hold you in my arms. Well, at least I know now that I can definitely take your breath away. Come here. Oh, really? You're going to play that way, are you? You won't even let me kiss you? Fine. That's okay. What's wrong with my face? Sinister looking? I don't know what you're talking about. I have no plans. I have no plans at all. Aha! Take that. Tickle. Are you going to stop my kisses anymore? Oh yeah? No. I'm not stopping till I hear you say sorry. What was that? No, I'm sorry, I can't hear you. No. Ha. Got you in the end, you little brat. Oh, well, sorry. Maybe I would have managed to actually kiss your lips and not your eyelid if you actually let me kiss you in the first place. Just thank all that's holy that I was not about to give you a hickey. Because, yeah, that would be messy as fuck. And I kind of just got here. I really don't spend my first hour skipping any. Especially after last time. I'm sorry, but you only cut, like, 4-3 layers of skin. No, hon, you did not nearly cut your bone. You were fine. Honey, all you had to do was put plasters and butterfly stitches on you. You got really freaked out and started crying all over the place. Hey, that's different. You know how stitches scare the fuck out of me. Ugh. No, it's not that. It's the thought of something sewing up my skin like I'm a broken pair of jeans that freaks me out. Blimey, you're scared of blood. I'm terrified of stitches. Injections. I said none of us are ever in a serious accident. 911, what's your emergency? My boyfriend has cut open his arm and, oh, hell no. Ugh, don't mention those. No. Promise me if I ever have to have one of those put inside me, you will knock me out. Tom and Jerry. Style with a fucking frying pan. Oh, come here. I miss it so much. I didn't even get any sleep last night. Exactly, that's sorry, that catch me. I know. I didn't fall asleep at bath this time. Oh my God, do you remember when you went up to go to the toilet at like 4 a.m. and you saw me in the bath absolutely out cold? Oh, you jumped a mile. You jumped all the way across the room. It was fucking hilarious. Speaking of jumping a mile or jumping the gun, I can't remember which one it is and what phrase means what, but, well, a couple of weeks ago, we had that row. Do you remember? Well, I know we, you know, made up and we're all on good terms now, but I still feel really bad. I said a lot of hurtful, evil shit back then, but I know I apologised and we said sorry, but there's something I need to get off my chest. I wasn't mad at you when you came over to surprise me. I wasn't. I just those moods again. And I'm not trying to whinge or anything, or, you know, doing this for attention. I tried to lock my stuff away that day. That's kind of what I do. When they come, I lock myself away from the world so that I don't do or say anything I regret. Because when they come, I'm like a lit piece of dynamite from the ground and the sky. And there is no stopping it going off until it goes away. And, I was an idiot. And when you walked in, I exploded. And I've been having these dreams recently, and I'm really scared. I should have. I'm really scared I'm going to lose you to another emotional outburst like that, or another episode. But I should have never have said those things, and I'm sorry for everything or anything that you heard or that came out of my mouth. You know what I'm trying to say is I'm sorry. I'm gonna do better. I really am. I've never had this happen. Well, at least I've never done it or exploited a partner. I mean, not with anyone I've ever been with. I mean, well, we've been together now for like 6-7 months, and that's longer than anyone I've ever been with. As long as anyone's ever stayed with me. And the fact that we lasted this long, and we never had one single disagreement or argument or even fallout, it kind of got me worried. And I kept thinking, okay, wondering why we weren't having arguments. I mean, I'm not saying I want to, I'm just saying it made me, you know, I kept thinking that when we did have one, it was going to be a really big one. And I guess that's what happened back there. And, you know, I just want you to know that I didn't mean any of those things. Not one. It's just, I tried everything that day to calm myself down. I tried everything from just trying to meditate. I tried exercising. I tried speeding up my heart rate to see if I could produce the effect in the brain that stops the depressive chemicals, and, you know, but it didn't suffice. Nothing worked. I felt so riled and angry at almost anything, you know. And I was trying to keep everyone away. That's why I locked the door. That's why I didn't want out. And you know, that's why I was kind of, that's why I tried to keep you away from me when you came in. And I didn't realise that by doing that, that you would wonder what the fuck was going on, what's wrong with me. And it just, what I'm trying to say is, I'm really sorry. And I do appreciate you, and I do love you. You know, I do care for you. I care for you a lot, and I really ought to know you a lot more often. No, I really should, because, you know, well, you do so much, not just for me, but for everyone. It may not feel like it, but to me, and, well, anyone, the amount of stuff you manage to do, the amount of effort you put in to anything you do, it astounds me. Just not by how you walked nearly my miles just to see me on one of your days off, or how you stayed in the hospital with me for 3 weeks and put up with my whinging. Your determination, even when it comes to video games, even though you could search up some playthrough and type in some cheat code and just fly through it, you will sit there for 4 hours until you get it right. You did, babe. You were on the Xbox at 12 o'clock. You were playing it for 15 hours. Even I haven't managed to do that. But you know, you do so much more than you realize. You work yourself into the ground without even knowing it. When I see you, when I gaze into those eyes, I see those. When I stare into those tender, gentle eyes of yours, I see the most caring, phenomenal person I've ever met in my entire life. I mean it, I do. No, trust me, it may seem like you're doing small little things here and there, but it's like you're moving mountains without realising it, and sweeping me off my feet in the process.
Thinking nothing on it, it's just that, it's not as sad, it's like how much you actually give a toss about the people around you, even those you barely know. You have such a open, caring attitude. This personality where you don't let anything bother anyone. You care so much. And so, for so many people. In such a way that I didn't even know existed. It just, it amazes me. And I envy you for that. I really do. Even your playful smirks you give, your sweet smile, there's this place inside my mind where I feel like I, not even a tank could harm me. Even when I feel your hair, this wave of happiness drowns me. When we hug, the sweet embrace of just knowing you're there, holding me, fills me with this warm ecstasy that stays with me all day, like a blanket of you, whispering your tender words into my head. God, I feel so blessed to have got you. Someone like you in my life. Sweet, generous, kind, funny, caring, unique, young, playful at heart. Not young, but playful at heart. Okay. Alright, don't hit me. Go on. You know what I mean, though, but someone who stands by me, who's dealt with all my ups and downs, but of all my crazy shit, and joined in with the crazy shit and kept the party going throughout the night. Someone to hug, tender kisses with. Sometimes I find it hard to believe that this is real. That it's like I wake up and I have to reach out and touch your face, because waking up to you, hell, even seeing you, it's like I'm staring at this mythological goddess, which words cannot comprehend. Like, your beauty, your face, your body, your skin, everything about you, it's like you're not from this world, but from this fairy tale land I wanna grab your hand with and just run off into. Even just being there in the same room with you, it's intoxicating. Like I'm drunk on your very presence. Honestly, you make me feel so, so blessed to have you. Like you're this holy essence that makes all my troubles just melt away. It's like you've enchanted me. Even when we say goodbye, your words and the memories of you give me this amazing strength. Like nothing could take me down from this high, like, feeling that you give. It makes my spine jump out of place and tingle over, like a warm-lit fire following me around. Even just your essence makes me completely lose control and flop to the floor. I could torture you for hours and hours on end, and I could just stay there with you, holding you, and it just makes me want to snuggle till we fall asleep in each other's arms. It's like your very soul is caressing me. No one, nothing, has ever made me feel like this. I love you. I know we haven't said that to each other yet, but I do. I love you dearly and deeply. When I see your face, when I feel your soft skin, when you call, when I hear that loving familiar voice, it lights a flame that just lights up my entire day. It sends rivers of cushions hugging my spine. It's like when I even see you, the times when we spend together, those moments, I could stand them for eternity. You're like this divine being. When I'm with you, it's like I've been taken to heaven in the soft arms of an angel. You're my soul, you're my very air that I breathe, the bones that keep me from falling apart. You're like this divine energy filling my lungs, this angel. You're my world, you're my universe, you're my stars that light up the sky above me, you're my galaxy, you're my everything, you're my all. If this is a dream, I don't ever want to wake up. If you're a drink, keep on pouring. If you're a drug, take me to the dealer. And if this is just one chapter in a fairy tale, I never turn in the page. So keep intoxicating me, because I ain't ever leaving. Happy Christmas, baby. Hey people, it's Dave from Celestial ASMR. I am very sorry I've only been able to upload a couple of videos. I had this one in the works for quite a while. I just hadn't got around to actually understanding a lot of the editing software I'm using recently, because there's a couple miss-ups and mistakes, and I was trying to cut them out, and it really was just not working for me, so. And I'm also sorry, I tried to, as hard as I could, to publish this on Christmas, but I'm only a couple of hours away, so, you know, I tried. But yeah, I am really sorry about, I'm sorry I can only do one video. I am now writing two scripts every week, and hopefully that will mean I'll be able to do two videos a week. I wish I could do one every day, that would be amazing. Maybe I'll get to that. But if you like this video, like, comment, and subscribe for some more. Bye!